So what do students at KTS think about voting?
Only 50% of Year 10 and 11th pupils would vote if given the chance, while only 14% support a political party and feel that a political party represents them. But most shockingly, two-thirds of students didn't care about politics at all.
We sent an intrepid team of newscast reporters to London to find out what Hertfordshire MP Sir Oliver Heal thought about votes for 16-year-olds and how little teenagers cared about politics.
Why do you think the Conservatives had a change of heart on votes for 16-year-olds?
Well, I think many of us were very impressed by the amount of engagement that there was during the Scottish referendum, where young people really did get involved, because the worry has always been that young people wouldn't necessarily take the opportunity. So I think that's the big change.
In a recent survey of 200 Year 10 and 11 pupils, only 50% would say they'd vote if given the chance, and only 14% said they would vote for one of the major political parties, not knowing them.
Yes. Well, I think that shows the battle that you have, really, to persuade your friends how important this is and to get them involved in politics, because it's not just about the politicians having to do this. It's about young people campaigning for issues and being part of it too. And so when the general election comes, you'll see lots of young people out on the streets campaigning for me, for the Conservatives in our area, and that's because they're engaged in the issues, not just because they've had a lesson about what the political system's about.
Two-thirds of the people we interviewed couldn't name all three of the major political leaders. What's your opinion on this?
Well, I think people have gone through a period where they've been less engaged in politics, but that doesn't mean politics isn't important. I mean, today we've got the budget. Now, every young person who goes out to work will see on their pay packet, tax deducted, national insurance deducted, how much is taken off is a big political issue. I think people should get engaged, but it's up to you.
Thank you for talking to us, Sir Oliver.
Sure. Pleasure to talk to you.
To celebrate 75 years, KTS took to the Gordon Craig Theatre in Stevenage to produce an extravaganza to rapturous reception. Here are the dancers and gymnasts, led ably by Miss Henderson and Miss Ward, performing beautifully. And this was just the beginning.
Red Nose Day at KTS was fully embraced by students and staff alike. We spoke to a number of people during the day.
What are you doing for Red Nose Day?
Well, I bought a red nose and I'm going to see the staff bake off at lunchtime. I bet it's going to be a close competition.
Numerous events took place in order to raise money for such a fantastic charity that included the Game Jam, which was a scratch game created by some IT students. They charged 50p to enter and gave many people an enjoyable break time.
So I'm going to add just a tiny amount of this to that ice cream, just make it look a lot more.
And even with my low expertise here, you have to be very careful with this.
Very careful. Just a moment, please.
The drama studio was filled with students waiting to see the competition and then to taste the cakes before voting for the winner.
Did you enjoy the bake-off?
I did enjoy the bake-off. It was a good way to spend lunchtime, and it's quite funny to see the teachers stress out your food tech. That's what we did, so.
Did you enjoy the bake-off?
Absolutely. It was absolutely hilarious. Really good effort from all the teachers and all money to Comic Relief. Really good.
Did you enjoy the bake-off?
I enjoyed the bake-off a great deal. I think some of the contestants were left red-faced rather than red-nosed at the end of it. Some cakes were definitely more successful than others.
I heard you helped to present the bake-off.
That's right, absolutely. I was invited to come and lend some sort of narration to the piece. Sadly, though, many of the disastrous moments that occurred in the bake-off didn't feature in the final film. I'm waiting for that to be released on DVD as extras.
On Monday the 9th of March, the KTS senior boys basketball team played John Henry Newman in an exciting fast-paced game. The game was a stressful watch for the spectators, with John Henry winning at numerous points, but the boys played incredibly well and overall proved too much for John Henry, with the game resulting in a 57-47 victory for KTS. After the game, Kate spoke to a number of team members to get their opinion on the win, including star player Nick Allen, who scored over 20 points himself.
North Arts champion 2015, 9 points
scored. So how did you feel after winning today?
It was a really good game. We should have closed it out a bit sooner, but we pulled it back in the end and we won.
I'm really happy that we won. They gave us a good match, but in the end I think we were just a little bit better.
So what were the turning points in the game?
I think we played well in the first half, especially. We let them come back in the second half. But we just managed to hold it out at the end and came out with the win.
We started off by throwing up some bad shots, but towards the end of the game we just hit our layups, the nice easy transition baskets, and then once they quit we just put them down.
Apart from yourselves, who played well and why?
I think Elliot played well. He was hustling really hard and he got some layups and he did well.
I thought Corriday played well. There's people a lot bigger than him and he managed to pull down some good rebounds.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
KTS has received funding to build a state-of-the-art science block on the land next to the new sixth form block. The £3 million building scheme will begin in June this year and be ready for September 2016. Mr. Swift said, "I am absolutely delighted with the news. Our hard-working staff and students deserve the best possible accommodation." Thank you.